So, this is an ode to Mark T. Smucker, a play written by me and Hunter Jones about something slightly related to biology, protein synthesis. And we just hope y'all enjoy. All right. Picture this, the quaint town of Nucleoshire, province of the great kingdom of Sinoham. In the house of Nucleoshire's fine duchess, Danielle N.A., we find her being painted by renowned artist Rosalind Franklin. At this time, Danielle is great with child. She is also in the nude to feel her beautiful but dark and twisted fantasies.
Oh, Rosalind, won't you paint me like one of your French girls?
With pleasure, madam. My, oh my, what a fine set of double helixes you have. Is all well, m'lady?
I fear not.
Oh,
my child is on its way.
Wee woo, wee woo, wee woo.
Don't worry, here's the doctor. Sit down, m'lady. All right. Just breathe.
I see the head.
What the deuce, mother? It was dark in there and smelled. Won't you clean sometime? Hello.
What would you like to name your child?
I would like to name...
It should be called Macbeth. And rule the world with an iron fist on the throat of my enemies.
Before I depart, Rosalind, you are not the father.
Let's go with me, you treacherous.
Jesus Christ.
In time, the boy Macbeth would develop into a great man and impeccable leader. He now possesses great ability, granted to him by the unique set of codons he was born with. He is loved by his friends and feared by his enemies. His prowess would soon be rewarded by an invitation from the king himself to claim his seat as lord of the endoplasmic province.
Mother?
What hear of you?
Before you must depart, my son, you must be well equipped on your journey. The path to Endoplasmic Berg is a treacherous and weary one. Take this 5-prime cap and this 3-prime tail to protect you on your journey. You will not need these anymore. Protect your exons at all costs. They are the sole source of your power.
Thank you, mother. You will not be forgotten. Maybe one day we will meet again on the night of half-price apps at the Apple of Bees.
Sounds good.
At this point, Macbeth did leave to do his duty, but he was not without his misgivings.
To fight or not to fight? That is the question. Whether it is nobler to sit on an uncomfortable throne and rule over many, or eat the comfort of a nice Smucker's grilled cheese, uncrustable from the comfort of one's own sofa. Whether it is the quarter of a pounder with cheese, or the Royale with cheese in thy Amsterdam. To die, to live uncomfortably.
Indeed, Macbeth's past was a treacherous one. He encountered many dishonest men and many gold-digging women. But just as he arrived at the borders of the Endoplasmic province, he would meet his greatest challenge yet.
I was trying to give you some time. Yeah, wait, let me cut this out.
There.
What are you doing in my swamp?
Who goes there? Reveal thyself.
And whom might thou be?
The name is Macbeth RNA, and I'm rightful lord of this province. Whom might thee be?
My mother christened me Ribosome, Richard Ribosome. My friends call me Rick, my enemies call me Dick. What shall it be for you?
If you shall not let me pass, then Dick it shall be.
Then so be it. Wait, can you pass me the light? Thou mother is so large when she sits around the house. She sits around the house.
Well, thou mother is so large that she needs 2 sundials, 1 for each time zone.
Your swordplay is akin to Joe's.
And who's my Joey?
Joe, mama. Tis over, for I have the high ground.
You underestimate my power. To be fair, Dick, it was over a long time ago.
Do not mock me. Wait. What is this? On jaw, these are the legendary codons. Tony, come hither.
What beeth the situation?
After years, we have finally found them. Legendary codons by an unfortunate accident.
Outstanding, can we?
Indeed, Tony. Give me your anti-codons and amino acids.
But
codons and anti-codons lie now perfectly. How? With this power, we can activate amino acids and summon a polypeptide.
How dost thou have thy anticodons? They anticodons and codons only run through my bloodline.
You are correct, for I am your sister.
No! How can this be? I'm done.
Well, I mean, she's a Tony RNA, you're Macbeth RNA, you have the same last name. It seemed kind of obvious to me.
Rick, actually, RNA is a pretty common last name around these parts, though.
Yeah, like Gary RNA? Yeah, not related to that guy at all. Just no blood relation.
Oh, I know Gary. I went to school with him. Yeah, we're not related at all.
Okay, thanks for the heads up. I'll keep that in mind next time I'm doing this. Anyways, with the activated power of these amino acids, I summon a polypeptide. Come forth, hemoglobin.
Who has awakened me from my slumber?
I, Richard Ribosome, have summoned you. With your power, I shall bring terror to Cytoham.
No one commands the spirit of hemoglobin to do to any task.
Very well then. With this polyribosome, I bend you to my will.
I am yours to command.
Hemoglobin, I command you to go forth and make Cytoham run awash with blood. With this, I have unlimited power.
Just kick me the sig.
What?
Kick me the sig.
And so, after Richard summoned a demon to bring terror to Cytoham, Macbeth finally breathed his last.
I'll see you in hell, Mark T. Smucker.
And his body did attract flies and maggots and mushrooms and worms and vultures and crows, but his soul lived on to see the pearly gates.
Hello? I would like to take this moment in honor of the late Kobe Bryant, his daughter, and all others who died in the plane crash, as well as their families and friends. We'd like to take a moment of silence starting now. Thank you. I think that's about 10-ish seconds. Okay, yeah. So. Thank you for coming out to SNL tonight. Kobe Bryant, Harry Styles. Yeah. I'm Eddie Murphy. See you all later.
Like, I think that was better than the first one.
That was better than the first one.
Yo, video.
Kobe. Hey!